Alright, we are back to play some more Last Guardian. How you doing, chat? Nook on 3 team. I'm not sure what that means. Well, that was one point JSE brought up. Who's JSE? What is JSE? If anyone's going to die, it's not going to be the kid because he's narrating at an older age. Yes. Which is another reason I think he's the shaman. Or there's a good chance that he's a character that we've already met. Logically, the ending calls for a mandatory death. It's probably going to be the creature. They have the player bond with it for hours. Yep. Imagine that at some point the game's going to expand a bit. Whether that means new characters or whatnot. But like Nook said, they're a smart writing team. I don't think they're going to kill anyone off. Maybe I'm wrong, though. Just think killing someone off is a little cliche. And obvious, unless they do it really well. Yeah. Well, cliche and obvious really isn't this team's MO, you know? In the last game, they resurrected a giant demon and turned the main character into a demon baby. You know, like, what? So, I trust the team to blow my mind. I really do. What happened when we pulled this? Oh, it just opened that. So he's out. So that's an important thing. He's out. Which means I can use him. We can try to jump that. Ugh. It's kind of scary. I don't know if we can jump that. Is that the bridge? Like, I keep looking at these bridges going, is that the bridge? Oh my god, you're so adorable and horrifying at the same time. So, I really want to get this food for him. It's over there. Jacksepticeye. Oh. I've never heard it called JSE. I'm not a fan, so I don't know the acronym. Yeah, some food, huh? Want some food? Cool, good catch, buddy. We'll get it next time. But it could be poised to do so, building up a bond with the creature. And have it die would have the impact that kind of did with the aggro. Right, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I totally agree. It makes sense for the creature to die for the emotional impact. Totally agree. Yeah. I was trying to think of an example of that not happening in a recent film, and I can't remember which one it was. I think it was Captain America. Or something. It was. I don't know. I don't want to spoil anything if people haven't seen movies. But why do these doors keep showing up, and why can't I access them? Ow! I just ran like headlong into it. Like ah! Boom! Knocked myself out. So what about those tattoos on the kid? Has that popped up anywhere before? So these tattoos. It said that he woke up with them. So he obviously didn't have them before he was taken into prison. And put away with the man-eater. We don't have any history on this kid, except he lives in a village. And the only history we have on Trico is that he was captured. And it looked like by men. Not by armored things, but by men. Who could have been in the village that we're from. The only other character that we've heard of is... He didn't call him the shaman, he called him the elder, I think. So it's someone else to just keep in our databank of connections. The butterflies, though, are intriguing to me. Because they're following this magic. This substance that we're giving him. It's the same substance that's holding together the suits of armor. it's obviously attracting these butterflies. There was that giant pot of it. What's up, Colonel 2005? This game I've been very skeptical because of the long production hell it seemed to be stuck in so long, but looks pretty good. It is so good, man. I'm really, really enjoying myself. Maybe I need to have him... You know what? Alright, we're gonna do this. I'm gonna pick this back up. You're gonna sit. Do it. Alright, I'm just gonna put this over here then. You obviously don't want it if you don't want to sit. It's like dealing with my own dog. Sit. There we go. Alright. Oh, he caught it! Yes! I've been waiting for that to happen. Hey, Pippin, how you doing, buddy? This game might make me dust off my PS4 and put my Xbox away for a while. Totally worth playing. I am seriously impressed by it. Really, really am. The AI on the beast is very, very cool. Oh, the tattoos. You were asking about the tattoos. I don't have a full connection to the tattoos. My link with me trying to link him up with the shaman, or, you know, trying to, like, prove that theory, is the shaman is covered from neck to wrist to ankle in Shadow of the Colossus. And so I believe that he's trying to cover up the tattoos. Don't know if it's true. At least not yet. Yeah, what is that, buddy? What is this door? You seem interested in it, too. Alright, never mind. You're walking away. We're done. Maybe this magical stuff you're feeding him prompts Dorman to become more prevalent. That is to say, if it is Dorman. Right, yeah. Well, the thing I was trying to say earlier that I got interrupted by him eating us. Can you jump? Oh god. Oh, what was that? He jumped, but there's nothing to jump to, apparently. Apparently he doesn't see that. He doesn't think we can make it over there. So earlier when those green... Ooh, I barely got on at the last second. Jeez, that was close. In that cage right before he ate us. There were those waves of, like, green energy. And that green energy is really reminiscent of the Queen from Ico. And she would appear... This, like, green orb would appear and then... Whoosh, and she would kind of wisp into existence. And it just reminds me so much of her. Again, it's like, ooh, this could be an Ico sequel instead of a thing. This is the fifth live stream I've been to. Well, welcome, Brian. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. I'm getting really leery of new people in chat because I'm worried somebody's going to be like, here's all the ending, this is the spoilers, blah, 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 blah. Can we not get through there? Nope, we're at a dead end? Alright. What to do? Oh, there's a thing. Go over here. Why are you pointing that direction? Yes, over here. You're like jump and he's looking at the abyss like where? Whoa! Whoa! Whoa, that's not kind of what I expected, but here we are. I'll take it. Thanks for the boost, buddy. Huh. I don't think I can make that jump. That's a long jump. Oh, ladder. I completely missed that at first. How did I not see that? Why does he have the tattoos? Some sort of prisoner's mark or something more magical. Right, it could be something to do with Trico. It could be some kind of connection to him. It could be a prisoner's mark, like you're saying. It could be a sign of crime or who knows. He's just a little kid, right? So it's like, what could he have done to land him as a prisoner? Was he captured by man, like the memory of Trico would lead us to believe, or was he captured by the suits of armor that we're now having to face? I think he would have woken up to the pain of the marking neck to ankle and tattoos, so it's some kind of magical thing. Yeah, leaning on the magic side. That's very true. It's a very good point. Alright, new music. Oh, is that like a sentry? It's like a Beamos from Zelda. That's one reason I'm really digging this, is because it's some of the aspects of having to like get through these temples, quote unquote, is very Zelda-like. And I don't know. I love Zelda, so to have that, some of those aspects of needing to sneak around guards and all that stuff. It's kind of cool. What if he got horns and they sawed them off when they captured him, and that's why he's in prison? This is a sequel, that is. It's true. They could be under his hair. The horns could be under his hair, and he could be like a child, like Ico. It's true. He said he woke up to them just being on, and he never described pain like you would experience after a fresh tattoo. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's definitely some kind of magical marking. I agree. I like your reasoning, and I see no reason to disagree with that. Solid logic. I'm not really sure where I'm headed right now. I see a ladder over there that we could get to, but there's a switch and then these two sentries. I feel like we need to pull that switch to get Trico through here. I'm also not sure 100% how to get down safely. Also not sure what those things are going to do to me if they see me. Speaking of Zelda, what do you think of Breath of the Wild? Looking at the game, the animation style seems similar, which is cool. I am so excited for Breath of the Wild. Yeah, that's gonna be good. I'm going to be making a video about that and where I think it plays in the timeline. There's a cool theory going around that I haven't read too much on, but I think I agree with it from what I've heard about it. And I've been kind of making my own judgments and assessments on it, you know? That was a long fall. I'm surprised they let me get away with that. Because the Zelda timeline is a very controversial subject, right? And I think I have a pretty good idea of how Oh! of how Breath of the Wild fits into it all. Alright, mate, I'm passing out with my laptop. Hey, no problem, man. Go get some rest, Lucius. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. You living up to your mod duties. That's really cool of you. Thank you. Tried to jump in, but I couldn't make it 5 minutes. The body is ready for Breath of the Wild. You like Zelda? Cool. Are you a fan of top-down or 3D ones? I love completing top-down ones. I wish I could contribute conversation, but I know nothing about that game. About this game. No, you're fine, man. You know, it's funny, I have people say that to me, like, I don't know what to say, so I leave, or I don't know what to say, so I feel really awkward, and it's like, you don't have to know anything about the game. Like, let's just talk, just ask me questions like you're doing. It's perfect. It works really, really well. Hey, calm down, buddy. Calm down. We're okay. Yeah, we're all good. So green is like love, I think. Yeah, green is definitely connected to the player. I think you're right, Dalton. So 3D ones versus 2D. So my first Zelda game was Ocarina of Time. So I obviously have an affinity for the 3D Zeldas. When he's angry, it scares me. I know. Like, it is. It's actually truly terrifying. I'm really scared that he's gonna, like, not come back one time. You know, like, he's gonna get so angry that he doesn't come back from it. Oh, so there's something below us here. So 3D Zeldas were my starting point. And then I went back and played Link to the Past. I played the first Zelda. I played, you know, I think I've played all of them by now. I haven't completed the Oracle games, but I've played them. And I haven't completed Spirit Tracks, but I've completed Phantom Hourglass. And my god, those things are just like shoving bamboo shoots up your fingernails. They're so awful and long and boring and so hard to control. My battery's low. And I'm not sure where I put the charge cable. Oh, there it is. So, to answer your question, fan of the top-down or the 3D ones? It all depends, man. Because there's been some really good 3D ones, and there's been some really good 2D ones, you know? It's all about execution. It's all about execution. And using the 3D space to your advantage, or using the 2D space in a smart way and to your advantage. It's just all about game design and sticking to the Zelda. I don't want to say formula, because the Zelda formula has become diluted, or more concentrated, I should say, as it moved toward Skyward Sword, which became a completely linear Zelda, which is the opposite of what Zelda was created to do, or created to be in the beginning. Mario and Zelda were created side by side for the NES, for the Nintendo, and Mario was created to be a completely linear game, and they were like, okay, well, Zelda is going to be a completely non-linear game. And so when you watch the game evolve into Skyward Sword, it's kind of depressing to see it go that way, right? Awesome, you're such a good cat bat. So I don't know. I don't. To answer your question, I don't think I have a preference. I think the 2D ones are really great sometimes, and sometimes they're not. And I think the 3D ones can be really great, and sometimes they're not. Wind Waker is like a masterpiece to a degree. The sense of adventure, the sense of exploring the world and being out on your own and all that stuff, like everything that comes along with that game is done so well. Sure, there's that part where you have to collect all the Triforce pieces, but they kind of remedied that with the HD version. That's fine, but that's like it's like finding a hair, one of your hairs, in something you've made for yourself. It's like, well, oops, I shed into this. You know, it's like, oh, whatever. Such a small problem to have with such a great thing. 2D Zeldas that I like a lot would be Link Between Worlds was fantastic. A Link to the Past, fantastic. Link's Awakening, I think, was my first 2D game, which I had on Game Boy Color. Oh, my Lanta. That did not work out the way I thought it was. I thought I was going to land on that thing. Minish Cap is really fun. I had such a good time playing Minish Cap. Yeah, I don't know. They're hit or miss, right? It's just sometimes they're great, sometimes they're not. And I have high hopes for Breath of the Wild. I have really high hopes. I love everything I've seen so far. They're going back to a classic Zelda that's completely non-linear. And I really, really dig that and really respect that, that they're able to take a step back and be like, okay, you know what? We've grown apart from what this was supposed to be, and now we're gonna go back, you know. This concentrate, like orange juice concentrate of a formula that Zelda has become, we're gonna get rid of it, we're gonna throw it out, and we're gonna go back to the original recipe, Colonel Sanders style. Anyway, back to chat. You got me on Zelda. I can talk Zelda all day. Is he gonna see me? I hope not. Completing Link's Awakening wasn't so bad to complete. Touchscreen controls, such. Touchscreen controls. Oh, crap! That was unexpected. I didn't think I was in his eyesight. Wow, they are terrifying in large groups. Go, 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 go! No, 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 no! What? Oh my gosh. It seems like the more of them are around, the harder it is to get free. Oh, jeez. The spells, they're so cool. I love that the spells are just buttons. Ugh. I love it. Oh dang, they're hitting me hard, they're hitting me hard! I'm not gonna be able to do this though, that's a problem. Crap! God dang it. I wonder how many times I can keep breaking free. I also don't know 100% what I'm supposed to be doing right now, like... I need to lure them down here, I guess, and then go back? Oh, okay. I can actually go this way instead of climbing up the pillar. And this is a way safer way to get up. Well, that said, I enjoyed Skyward Sword. It's not... It wasn't great, but there were things that I liked about it. I loved having the backstory for the entire Zelda franchise, since it's the very first game in the timeline. That's what I was excited about, you know, the beginning of the kind of, I don't know, the beginning of Zelda, Ganon, and Link, you know, right? So, it was just a cool thing to finally see. Oh man, you got donkey kicked. Holy crap. Get him. Get him. Smack. Did you get them all? Did you get them all? I think we're good. I think we're good. Alright, come on. Hey, 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 come back here. Come back here. It's okay. It's okay, they're gone. They're dead. They're dead. They're dead. He's dead. Trico. Come on, Trico. I'm gonna rub your butt. I'm gonna rub your butt just like you like. Just like you like. Hey. 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 It's okay. It's okay. There you go. You are terrifying. I've actually only played two games and never all the way through. One of them was already played almost all the way through. For Zelda? You never played a full Zelda game? Wow. Speaking of Link's Awakening, quick trivia, if you don't die throughout the whole game, you get a secret cutscene. I did not know that. Or if I knew that, I had forgotten. That's really cool. You're clearly some form of defense to make sure that Trico doesn't escape, right? Trico or the kid? That's a good question, Doug. I mean, the other creature we saw earlier was wandering around pretty free. That's very true. Skyward Sword had an amazing story. Yeah, that's cool. Finally, someone in the world. Yeah, I think the story was great, but the execution wasn't so great. Yeah, having to fight, not Demise, but having to fight, what was that damn thing called? A giant black egg with tumor toes. Whatever it was. Having to fight that thing over and over and over was so dumb. And, yeah, I don't know, that's... That's Skyward Sword. It's just, it had issues. It was not perfect, and a lot of people knew that. Maybe both? Probably both. They wouldn't have employed all these artificial forces for one child, unless he was really powerful. Why does Trico get so upset when he kills the stone guys? I think he's just like... Yeah, he's definitely like super triggered about whatever they are. I can't wait to learn more about this eye and what it means. I think we have to stand him up, or should I go down? No, I don't think down's an option, actually. Now to get a better look. All right, this is not what I had in mind. Was that a door? All right, I'm done. I'm down. This is not a door. Haru. And a jump down there. Oh, is this just for you? Is this just platforming for Trico right now? The imprisoned. That's who it was, chicken. Keep going. Is that sand? Oh, it's water. I was like, is that sand pouring in from above? Do it. Yeah. Where are we going next, huh? What's next? What's... Oh, okay. Up there, probably. Can't see the kid being as powerful as that, all the damage being dealt by Trico. Well, it doesn't mean powerful. I shouldn't have said powerful. Important. It's like capturing a princess, right? Like, who knows who this kid is, what he's worth. But Trico was chained up. That's a big difference, right? Trico was chained, and the kid was just laying there. Depends on the child, like a child shaman, yep. Kid is resisting all those spells. That's true. More than I assume a normal kid would, suggesting magical aptitude. That's a really good point. I hadn't even thought about it that way, but you're absolutely right. We were resisting some kind of like crazy mind control paralyzing spell. Like, what is, you know, what does that do to you? Can't see a need for hundreds of guards. If he can resist this magic, then why employ tactics using the magic that he can resist, but the creature can't? Another genius point. Are his horns getting longer? I think his horns are growing. They were flat. They used to be flat. They were flat at the beginning. I remember specifically looking at them and seeing that they were flat. His horns are growing. Who called that out earlier? Was that Doug? You're saying that his horns would slowly grow and you wouldn't notice it? I'm proud you thought of something that Nook didn't. Yeah, it's not that hard to do. It's easy to seem like super I don't know if, not intelligent, intelligence not the right word, but super observative and, I'm not sure what the word is, but it's easy to seem that way when you release a really strongly scripted, edited, researched piece of work, whether that's a paper or a video, you know. But then you meet me and I'm like, but it's just because I spent so much time and energy looking into that. And that's why it seems like, I don't know. It's like listening to game theory. You're like, my God, Matt Pat's a genius, but Sure, he's intelligent, but he just does his homework, you know? He does his research. Where the hell am I doing? I know I need to get this thing, this chain, to get pulled down. I pulled a switch. What did the switch do? I need to really pay attention to what switches do. Oh, I'm gonna die. That was a long fall, and my shins are not broken. I'm gonna say that the forces were intended for this specific creature. Why? Not sure. Yeah. You can make that assumption. That's how theories begin, man. You gotta have constants in order to have variables. Woo! Wah! Woo-hoo-hoo! So he likes playing with this thing. I don't think we're going to be able to get him to play with it, though. I was trying to jump to him. Yeah, there he goes. Alright, come back down here. The food is making the horns grow. Either that, or is the mist that explodes from the guards, and that was in the pot earlier. You make Trico pull the chain. I think so, but I think you have to bait him with food or something. I know you've already jumped up there twice, but take me. Take me with you. Maybe the kid was imprisoned here, but I don't think it was expected for him to become linked with the creature or be able to resist the spells. Yeah. It's true, too. Why is it still giving me tutorials? Yeah, look at that. There it is. That's the chandelier we need to get Trico to play along, for sure. Maybe the tattoos are his link to Trico, and Trico is giving him magical properties. That's interesting. Maybe Dorman is kind of in both of them. Knowing that, like, he needs the human's intelligence to get the beast that he's imprisoned in to do what he needs him to do, or something. Okay, so there's the blue goo. What's the lever do? It's not that far of a stretch at all. No, it's totally possible. He woke up with no memory, with tattoos next to a giant creature that he's unarguably connected to. All right, hup. Take this back over to the other lever, and or the chain. You should go for it. Oh man, get tired. Might have to call it here in a little bit. That sucks. But my body's like, yo, you running on no sleep. Can I pull these off? Like, this looks like I should be able to open this. Yeah. Huh. Cool. I really didn't know if that would work or not. I'm gonna open up both of these. Imagine what catnip would do to Trico. Alright, so now he's like, oh god. Yes! Yes! Fumble our way back over here to the chain. Yeah. Thanks for the catch. Do we need it yet? No, no. Not for Trico. No! Did he just sneeze on me? Ah, dang it, I should have taken the stairs. Oh crap, the stairs are on the other side. Okay. Alright. Snack. Trico's body is ready for the glowing blue snack. You betcha. Can't climb down with this thing, I'm gonna throw it. I actually hoped that I would throw it and it would land on the chain, was kind of my hope there. That did, not pan out. Did not pan out. He's like, what the? Hey, keep pulling on it. Keep pulling on it. Go that way. Go that way with it. Oh my god! Whoa! Holy crap, that was close. So I've actually seen this part of the game, so I kind of know what to do here. This was the bit that PewDiePie got to play. Good giant death cat. Good boy. Good lord. I know, right? God. I really thought I was gonna get smashed. I really thought we were dead for a moment there. Come on, kid. Push with your I don't know. Your monk strength. I don't know. Dude, you gotta play with that some more. Get in there. You haven't emptied it out yet. It's just like a Kong. It's a Kong for Trico. There's some treats in there. You just gotta lick it out. Lick it out. Pull. Come on. There we go. Alright, so the door is open. Trico can come through. And I got food. Heck yeah. You don't have muscles, use your tattoos. Use your tattoo strength. That metal thing's gonna weigh a ton. Yeah, seriously. Kid has to be magical. How else could he push that thing? Pardon. Sorry. It's getting late here. Not even that late, but it's old man late. That's for sure. Alright, buddy. You want some food? Yeah, you do. Come get some food. Sit. Good. Oh, yeah. I know you're all excited. You gotta sit though. You gotta sit. Sit. Come on. All right. Can you catch it at least? Yeah. I love that I feel like I taught him that, but it's just programming. Some really awesome, awesome programmers and animators made him do that. This game's incredible. You're gonna jump up there or not? Go! Oh, whatever, man. Alright, come on. That was a weird noise. Ooh, we got... It was a striking design akin to the in shape eye of shape. The beast seemed transfixed and at the same time terrified. So what's so cool, even though it's programmed, it feels like a totally real creature that's learning things, yeah. Why is the eye so important? I don't know, it's a new element from this game. I can't remember anything from the previous two games where an eye has been an important icon or an important symbol. So I'm sure it'll be linked to something or someone later. I really... what can I do? Oh, here we go. Check this out. I'm gonna smash it. Was the queen known for having eyes? No. There's nothing remarkable with the queen's eyes. Trico's eyes are important. They could be related. You are absolutely right. Doug, you are on it, man. You are totally on it. Eyes... are important in this game. Better now? Yeah, it's alright, buddy. Broken glass, walks right on it. Yeah. Let's go, man. Let's do it. This is the part. This is like the part from the trailers and the gameplay trailers and the everything. I think. Oh, yeah, it is. Oh my god, we're finally here. I know the eyeballs down there, dude. I know. I'm trying to take a moment and analyze. I want to look at the city. I want to see if I can see the tower of the shrine from Shadow of the Colossus. Although I feel like we've been through an entire city. I don't know if we're going to be able to see a shrine. see the shrine, but we're definitely in a walled place, which is where, you know, the shrine is. The shrine is in a completely walled off world. Oh yeah, and there's that in the cinematic trailer. There's the, you can see that, like, this world or this city exists in, like, a crater. Eyes and butterflies. Coincidence? I don't think so. Oh yeah, look at those horns. That left one is, like, way more grown out now, right? When I first got here, I thought you were referring to Trico the Pokemon. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Trico is the name of the creature. If this is a sequel, it must take place hundreds of thousands of years after Shadow of the Colossus, just because that's a lot of city to build. Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. And we're gonna have to push this one. All right, milk jug, get out of my way. Sorry guys, just wanted to take a quick look around again, now that we're kind of out here. Alright. Nothing's really striking me, if you're wondering. If you're wondering why I'm just, like, looking around. Yeah, I'm not sure if I could say that this technology is more advanced or less advanced than it was in previous games. Oh. Those dolls hanging from the eye? I don't know. I didn't get that good look at them, I guess. You over there. Did you get it? Yes. Oh boy. Hang in there, Trico. This is nerve-wracking. We've never had to trust him like this before. As many times as I've seen that in the trailers and knew that it was coming, that was such a really cool feeling. It was really well done. Because we spent 4 hours with this creature, and we just got to the point where we can tell it to, like, sit, and finally getting a little bit of control over it, and all of a sudden we have to trust it to catch us or we die. That's, like, some real shit right there. It's really cool. Yeah, that totally is a doll, I believe. At least that one in the back there. Ones up front just seem like little windsock type of things. I don't know why I'm pushing these off. It sounds like a terrible idea. You missed. You missed. You missed again. Oh, the tail. Yeah, just go. Just go. You got this. I'm on you, man. Holy crap. Climb! Climb! What's up, O22ISCO? Welcome to the stream. How are you doing today? Oh, come on. We gotta get up there. We gotta get in my hand somehow. Oh, we can. We actually have to, yeah. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Go, 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 go! We gotta help him out. We gotta get this jar out of the way. Get out of here. Can you climb onto that? Can you grab that? I don't know what to do. Grab it, grab it, grab it. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Please jump. Oh, God. Yeah, I've seen this part before, but as many times as I have watched these trailers analyzing them, that was still incredible to play. That was awesome. Oh my god. This is so much fun. What's up here? Alright, nothing if I were to climb those greens. That was the only thing I was looking for. Alright, what's behind you, Trico? Where are we headed here? What are you looking at, actually? What are you staring at? Oh, the hanging eyes. There's all kinds of hanging eyes out there. Well, there's our doves or our pigeons flying around everywhere, too. Alright. I cannot get off of him right now. I tried every single way I could to get off of him, and then I ended up just floating into space. Please tell me we're already on the other side of all that mess. Good. Good. We are. You know what? I can't think of a better way to end the stream except on that incredibly epic note that we just ended on, or that we just went through. So I am going to go ahead and call the stream for tonight right there. It's such an incredible game. I am super tired, and I need to rest for tomorrow because I have to go to work. So I'm going to call it tonight. We will pick this up Thursday night. Let's go ahead and schedule another stream for Thursday night. Tomorrow night I have a class and I can't stream, but Thursday for sure. And also Thursday morning I'll be streaming Stardew Valley, so come and hang out there too. Will the next stream be on YouTube? Yes. I'm not switching to Twitch just yet. The Switch will be like in January sometime. But yeah, so don't worry about that. For now, we're all YouTube all the time. Yeah, thanks, Doug, for hanging out. Thanks, Chicken. Thank you, O22. Thank you. There was another new person, a couple new people that were hanging out with us tonight. So thank you so much for stopping by. It means a lot. And thanks, Dalton. Always good to see you. And yeah, see you guys next time.